Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss perquisites, taxable for specified employees only. Meaning of specified employees under Section 17, Subsection 2, Clause 3 and Rule 3. Meaning of specified employee. A specified employee may be a director of a company. He or she has a substantial interest in the affairs of the company or hold at least 20% of voting power or equity shares in the company. His or her monetary annual salary is greater than Rs. 50,000 per annum. Salary for this purpose shall be basic salary plus DNS allowance plus DNS pay, additional DNS allowance, bonus, commission, fees, all taxable allowances, plus any perk received in cash, gratuity, pension, leave salary, salary received from other employer shall be considered as a part of salary. Monetary salary will be calculated as salary, as we have discussed, less deductions under Section 16. According to Minimum Wages Act 1948, an employee who will receive more than Rs. 50,000 as the annual monetary salary for the value of perk, all those employees will become specified employees. The value of free or concessional benefits shall be included in the salary income of specified employees. These benefits are facility of car, facility of gas, electric, energy and water, education, facility to family members of employee, sweeper, watchman, gardener and personal attendant, and transport facilities. Let's discuss one by one. Facility of motor car under Rule 3, Subsection 2, valuation of motor car taxable only for specified employees. Motor car is owned or hired by employer and given to employee. If the vehicle is fully used for official purposes by the employee, then the value of perk shall be nil. If the vehicle is fully used for personal purposes or private purposes by the employee, then the value of perk shall be taxed. This perk shall be taxable as employee is getting direct benefit and his personal needs are being fulfilled. So, actual expenses incurred by employer on running and maintenance of car, including depreciation, plus salary of driver or chauffeur, plus normal wear and tear of car, it will be taken as 10% of actual cost. If employer is charging some amount from employee, that shall be deducted. The resultant figure will be value of perk. As we have discussed that if the car is used for official purpose, then the value of perk shall be nil. And if the car is used for private purpose, then we have calculated the value of perk. And the third case is, if the car is used for both purposes, that is official or private purposes, or we can say that mixed use. This point is very important from examination point of view. Let's discuss in detail. Expenses on running and maintenance are met or reimbursed by employer. Here we will consider cubic capacity of engine. If it does not exceed 1.6 liters, then the amount shall be taken Rs. 1800 per month. But if the cubic capacity of engine exceeds 1.6 liters, then the amount will be considered Rs. 2400 per month. Second point is, expenses on running and maintenance for private or personal use are fully met by employee. Then the cubic capacity, if the cubic capacity does not exceed 1.6 liters, then the amount shall be considered Rs. 600 per month. And if the cubic capacity of engine exceeds 1.6 liters, then amount is equal to Rs. 900 per month. And if the facility of driver is also given, then Rs. 900 per month shall be added in point 1 or 2. If the driver is not given, then the same will not be added. Then what will be the value of perk? Amount specified for use of motor car plus rupees 900 per month for salary of driver. This will be considered as a value of perk. Car is hired or taken on lease by employer and it is used by employee or by his or her family members exclusively for private or personal purposes, then the value of perk shall be amount spent on running and maintenance of car plus remuneration, if any, paid to the driver. But if employer charges some amount from employee, that will be deducted and the resultant figure or value shall be treated as value to be taxed. Second point we will discuss, that motor car is owned by employee but expenses on its running and maintenance are borne or reimbursed by employer. Motor car is being used wholly or exclusively for official purposes. Remember, if the same is used for official purposes, value of perk shall be nil. That is no value to be taxed, but a logbook must be maintained by employee. Second point is, motor car is being used for both official or personal purposes, then the value of taxable perk shall be actual amount of expenditure incurred by employer, rupees 1800 per month for small car and rupees 2400 per month for large car, plus 900 rupees 900 for driver or higher sum for official purposes subject to certain conditions. Employee's car used for private or for personal purposes and car's expenses are met or reimbursed by employer. Value of taxable perk shall be the amount spent and reimbursement by the employer for the personal or private or for household purposes by employee. Amount spent includes expenses incurred on running and maintenance of car plus driver's salary. If employer is charging some amount from employee, then the same will be deducted. The resultant value will be value of taxable perk. Employee or any family member of employee uses more than one car, more than one belonging to the employers for personal or private purposes. Employer owned or hired more than one motor car, or employee or any family member is allowed to use such motor car or cars for personal or private purposes other than official use, then the valuation of one car as per the employee's choice is equal to rupees 1800 per month for small car or rupees 2400 per month for large or big car. And if the driver is also provided, then rupees 900 per month shall be added. And if the employer is charging some amount from employee for the use of such car, the same shall be deducted and the resultant figure shall be the value taxable perk. Valuation of other motor car or cars. It is assumed that the motor car or cars is exclusively used for personal or private purposes and the value shall be determined in the same way as we have already discussed in point 1b. When car is owned by employer or in point 1d, when the car is hired or taken on lease by employer. These points we have already discussed. The basic difference is that how we can calculate the value of motor car if more than two or more cars are given. Where more than one car is given for private purposes and the expenditure incurred in relation to one motor car are more than the expenses incurred in relation to the other car, or out of those cars, then if one car is small and other car is large, then the rules do not provide the method for valuation in such a particular situation. Value may be determined in such situation which is beneficial to the employee. Employee owns any other automotive conveyance and the expenses on running and maintenance are borne or reimbursed by employer. In such situation, if the employee uses his or her own conveyance only for official purposes, then value of perk shall be nil. That is, no value to be taxed, but logbook needs to be maintained properly. But if employee's conveyance is used for both private or personal or for official purposes of the employee, then the value of taxable perk shall be actual amount of expenditure incurred by employer and less amount of rupees 900 per month or higher value for official purposes subject to certain conditions. Conditions for claiming higher amount of deduction for official purposes applicable on second and third points. Employer is required to maintain the record or details of journey performed for official duties. Journey may cover date of journey or visit, destination, mileage and amount of expenditure incurred thereon. A certificate regarding the expenditure incurred wholly or exclusively for official purposes was given by employer. Facility of sweeper, watchman, gardener and personal attendant under Rule 3, subsection 3. The value of perk shall be salary paid by employer to the sweeper, watchman, gardener or PA less the amount recovered from employee, if any, the balance shall be value of perk. Then, facility of gas, electric energy and water under Rule 3, subsection 4. The value of perk shall be amount paid by employer to the agency providing the facility of gas, electricity or water, or if such facility is given from the own resources of employer, then the cost of production per unit. If employer is charging some amount from employee, that will be deducted and the balance shall be value of perk. Next important point is educational facility to the family members of employee under Rule 3, subsection 5. If the educational institution is owned and maintained by employer, and if the employee is getting free educational facilities due to the employment, then educational facility provided to employee's children, if the cost of such education or benefit per child does not exceed rupees 1000 per month, then the value of perk shall be nil. If the cost of such education or benefit per child does exceed rupees 1000 per month, then the cost of education in similar institution in that locality, and if employer charges some amount from employee, the same will be deducted and resultant figure will be value of perk. Education facility provided to other family members of employee, then cost of such education in similar institution in that locality, we will deduct the amount recovered from employee, if any, the resultant figure will be value of perk. If the educational facility provided in any other education institution, school or college to the children or family member of employee, the value of perk shall be expenditure incurred by employer. Reimbursement or payment of fees. In that case, fees of family members of employee is either paid or reimbursed by employer directly to the education institution. It is taxable perk whether the employee is a specified employee or non-specified employee. And the last point is transport facility under Rule 3, subsection 6. If the employer is engaged in carriage of passengers, goods or provides the facility of private or personal journey to any employee, to any member, family members of employee free of cost or at concessional rate, the value of perk shall be the value at which such benefit or amenity is offered by such employer to the general public, that is normal fare of freight chargeable from general public minus amount charged from the employer from the employee, the balance shall be the value of perk. That's all. Thank you so much. Thank you. Take care.